As a result of the election here in the United States, a number of people have come up to me and said, Father, what do we do? How do we fight back? They fear that certain freedoms may be encroached upon, including even the freedom of our religion and worship. Whenever I answer questions like that, I like to point to people much greater than me, or sources greater than me, such as the scripture, the liturgy, the teaching of the church, or men like these. These three bishops were martyred under communism in the land where my church came from, the area that is now Slovakia, Ukraine, that region of Europe. And what they did was, they did two things. These two things are my answer to those who ask, how do we fight back? We can't take this lying down if we're going to be encroached upon. Those two things are, number one, they deepened their relationship with Christ. They were more repentant, more humble, more charitable. They got closer to Christ and closer to their people that they served. The second thing was, yeah, they resisted. Sometimes we think just praying and having faith is like kind of like wimping out. You know, it's not strong enough. What are we going to do? Well, that's the first thing, is you have to deepen faith. We have to repent, renew. But they resisted by doing things like this. When the communists came up and said, deny the faith, deny the church, and then you'll be okay, you'll have a good life. They very adamantly said, no, I would rather die than to deny my God and my church. So you see, they resisted very strongly, ended up being martyrs. That's why they're painted here in the icon. They resisted, but not by punching people out, not by storming buildings, not even by parading and demonstrating. They didn't do it by hurting anyone, shooting anyone, fighting. They did it by firm resistance to the truth, by speaking the truth courageously and not backing down. That's the two ways in which we can fight back, in which we can preserve freedoms if they're encroached upon. First and foremost, get close to Christ, deepen our relationship, repent, renew. And then, yes, when need be, resist, but not with violence, with firm strength, but with charity.